Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another video. It has been a very long time since I've made a video, or a flight video. I'm hoping to bring this back, finally. A lot of new things, not a lot of new products, but a lot of new things I purchased that necessarily aren't new products, but they are new for me, because I haven't showcased them yet. Yeah, one of them being the Flat Factor 8-20. I am a beta tester for it, not just public, but also private. I've been part of it for months now. So I've been getting grips to this aircraft quite a while. And then some purchase things that I have here is X-Enviro, Ground Handling Deluxe, which hasn't been showcased yet, and I believe that's it. This scenery, believe it or not, is freeware. It looks absolutely amazing. This is Bordeaux, I believe that's how you pronounce it in French. Airport, it is Lima, Foxtrot, Bravo, Delta, and it looks absolutely great, and it is freeware, I believe. I don't remember buying this. This is freeware on the, or we could just look it up, Lima, Foxtrot, Bravo, Delta, and it is absolutely amazing. The reason why I don't know if this is freeware or not, or I'm not 100% sure, but I'm pretty sure it's freeware, is because I recently purchased quite a bit of scenery. That one of them we'll be flying into, and that is Barcelona. We'll be flying into Barcelona today. It's a very short flight with easy aircraft. We are on VATSIM, as you can see, so we're online. No ATC though, but we're still online. We'll be easy. We're easy 4233. Service from Bordeaux, I believe, to Barcelona. That's how you can pronounce it, if you can pronounce it. But I'm not going to continue pronouncing it correctly because I'm not going to pretend like I know the languages. So I'm just going to speak English and pronounce it my English way. Alright, so if you guys are lucky and own this aircraft, you know how amazing this aircraft already is. But even that said, things are still work in progress. And there are a lot of things that still haven't been simulated and will not be simulated for a little while. But will be once it's publicly released. And once I go over those, I'll mention them, but I won't go into detail about what's wrong and what's right. I'm just going to show you, or let you guys know, this is not simulated at the moment, but might, or most likely will, because they have mentioned it previously. With that said, I hope you guys had a very good holiday, very good Christmas, and let's get right started. So there's the flight deck at the moment. I'll go ahead and raise those. And so, hold up, empty. I'm just gonna empty this whole thing out. Set. What just happened? Jump to my hole. What? Why did that go away? That's odd. Okay. That's fine though, easily call him up again. Anyways, fly. Okay, so everything's still connected otherwise. So let's go and do the preliminary flows. Master switches are off, mode selector is normal, gears down, wipers are off, batteries are off, bolts at least 25.5 volts. That's good. Okay, make sure weather radar is off. Which it's not simulated, so there's nothing we can press and predict. Winter should be off. Exterior lights all off. And then we can connect the extra power. I'm gonna adjust my lighting a little bit here. No need for some of this integrity lights. Integrity lights. Foot lights can go away. Integrity lights can be dimmed. Foot lights go away. Why does it do that? Oh, probably because of. Actually, I don't know. Weird. Let's go and extend some tables here. Now we just wait. So everything's booted up correctly. Alright, you can tell we have quite high wind speeds because our engines are rotating quite fast. If we check that. Anyways, you can see rotating, and this is actually calculated speed, so this is probably how fast it would rotate in real life too. Alright, system is active, you know that it is once you get some warnings up in here. So once that's complete with the APU fire test, make sure everything displays as it should. I'm not going to go into the details, I'm just going to say things to say. If I really wanted to go into details, I would make a story out of this, but I'm not going to do that. Parking brake is on, extra pressure can be raised, so LED pump. And make sure it's in the green. Go back off. Flaps up, indication degrees. Spoilers disarmed. Probe and window heat is auto. Faults are normal. Temperature select set. Make sure this is auto. We would select this, but it's also currently not simulated. Faults are normal and no white lights for ventilation. That is checked. Ventilation is actually quite important because without ventilation, these systems can overheat and cause a fire. And we don't want that. We do not want that. Alright, recall. Check, that's our only message, so we'll clear it out. Now we got a status, and it's TCAS. Some more things missing, but we'll get to that. They'll get to that eventually. Okay, check, we've got a couple doors open as you can see. Oxygen pressure is above 1500 psi, that's checked. Internal quantities above 9.5 quarts, that's checked. And our hydraulic quantities are in the green, that is checked. Alright? We're good to go there. So with that, we're going to go ahead and load our aircraft. So call that, that. We've got 3,402 kilograms in the front, and 3,892 in the middle. Set that. Packs, we've got 16, 60, and 47. Set that, and then fuel. Fuel will do. There's two different ways you can do fuel. You can do it realistically or unrealistically. Unrealistically is just setting the exact amount, putting set, and then you've got it. Or you can do it through this panel here. You click power, pre-select what you want. We today need only 5.6, I'm going to do 5.7 because it's 5,660, so I'm going to do 5.7 here. 5.7, and then hit control, and it fills up in real time, as you can see. Ah, it is raining. Let's go. Alright. And that is it. Now I'll do the overhead scan. A couple things not simulated here. We check that the crew supply is in auto. It would be off, but we can't do that right now. We checked the recorder, which is also currently not simulated. Faults are normal, no white lights. This is also not simulated. Let's make sure this is set to captain though. And we align the IRS. 1, 2, and 3. We'll get the on-bat light and we'll make sure that extinguishes before we move on. You see the IRS online message pop up. Alright, this is normal. Strobe auto nav system 1. Seatbelt signs stay off because we're refueling at the moment. No smoking auto. Emergency exit lights arm. Also currently limited. Make sure this is an auto off. Pack flow stays on normal. We have more than 100 passengers. And our temperature is not above 35 degrees Celsius, so we're good there. Pack faults are normal. Cabin and everything here is good. Everything here is normal as well. We're going to do a battery test. So let's get up the displays. Go to electrical. System 1 off. That's checked. And system 2. That is checked. Oh, very low amperage. Very low amperage. That's, I haven't seen that before. Okay, fuel pumps also stay off because we're still refueling. So that stays off and we'll turn those on later. In a fire test. Okay. 1, 2. And make sure the audio switching is normal, which is no click spot, so not simulated. Again, no white lights. Everything here is good. Everything here is normal. PA is tuned. We'll set that to around 50%. And make sure nothing here is on. That's checked. And we can now continue down to here. We can't do much here yet. We'll be setting our UNH very soon. Bugs we're not going to set. we don't need landing system. We can turn off our brightness if we wanted to, but there's no need to. DMEs, that's fine there. Okay, gears down. Expression's green. Checking our UTC. It is 12:14 UTC time. Just verifying that one last time here. Yeah, we're good there. Another steering is on. Everything here is normal. Perfect. And we'll now move down to the MCDU. Little crazy thing I do, which not a lot of people do, but real pilots do, is they deselect any nav aids that are out of service or anything like that. So, I will check my NOTAMs. See if there's anything wrong in real life. Nothing for departure. And I believe nothing for arrival either. Doesn't look like it. We're good to go. There are no nav aids that need to be deselected. They're all working in perfect order, so that's good. Aircraft status engines are correct. We do not have updated nav database because they don't haven't released any information on that to Navigraph yet, so they're trying to hold back because it's still beta, so that's why they're still holding back on that. So that's fine. But at least it's not like too old. Hope we get a new update soon with that though. We are at Lima Foxtrot Bravo Delta. Going over to Lima Echo Bravo Lima. Okay. IRS. We'll make sure that 4450 3 and 0420 the line IRS. Alternate is today Lima Echo Delta. Flight number is easy. What was it? 4233. Cost next will be 10. Cruise level will be 330. Go flight plan. Departure runway 23. The SAO 1. Actually, the South 3 pop up, but we don't have that. We're fine there. Temporary insert. Insert. And we've got a couple of airways going. Alpha 25. Alpha Golf November. Uniform November. 727. Set our star since it probably will not change. So expecting runway 25 left. Now that's the thing I need to look up is either Yankee or Zulu. Let's go and check our charts. You won't see this, but I'm gonna do it here. So 25. Left here's Zulu. Okay, that's Zulu. Yankee. Very similar. So we're gonna use Yankee. Team Yankee. The Puma 1K. Oh no, we don't have Puma. Great. So we'll go by them. Hopefully we have them right here. We do not. Okay. So do we have... Wait. Charlie Lima Echo. And we'll enter that. We'll see what we get. centered. Can we cross check that? That should be 70 nautical miles. Difference 16. Yep. Alright, we're good. Insert. Alright, we've got all our waypoints in. I'll go to Rad Nav. Bravo Delta. ADF. That's that one, 393. Got less than a minute before IRS are aligned. Okay, and no VORs that we need. I'll cross check that with my charts really quickly here. Actually, we really do not need any VORs. Alright, we're good there. GPS primary. Alright. Our IRS have aligned, and so we're good there. Div. So that's all we need. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back to NN2. We're going to enter our wind data. And, so our climb winds are 300-350. That's 6,000. Update next phase. This is cruise. Bamra is our first one that we're going to enter. Here we go. That is at 314.65. And our last one is the Volcan, which is 314.62. Update, and that's all we can enter for now. Now to get NNB. In this phase, you do the whole FMC with the information that you are presuming. So with this NNB page, we're presuming these are the weights and the fuel that we'll be getting. Later, we will revise this. Same thing with the performance page. We're going to use the performance page. We're going to enter all the performance that we think we're going to get, but not necessarily are going to get, because we're going to recalculate all that once we get our true values. So our expected values for our zero fuel weight is 58.7. Okay. Well, there's no need to put the center of gravity in yet. We'll do that later. Because this actually helps not to put it, because if it's not enlarged, you know something's not up here and you need to revise it. Alright. So block fuel, we're expecting 5.6. Okay. So we'll put that in there. And now we get some information here. And now we go to performance page. Wait, transition altitude. 5,000 is fine. We'll enlarge that. I'm going to do NADP 1, I believe. So we'll go to 170. 1670. Flaps 1. So we're expecting we're not going to put in our trim, because we do not know our exact weight at the moment, therefore we do not know our center of gravity yet, so we cannot calculate this. So we'll just put flaps 1. That's perfectly fine for now. We're assuming it's a temperature of 56 for now. And these are speeds that we presume we'll be getting, that we've calculated previously, but we'll recalculate them later. Once our conditions change, things like that. So 139. 41. These are calculated, these are not estimated or guessed. These are actually calculated from the time before we did the flight, but because weather changes, all kind of stuff changes, I'm gonna keep it at stuff. You calculate them right before pushback again, and then you enter those values. If they're the same, then great, and nothing changed. But if they're not, it's good to change them. Alright, so that's all we're gonna set for now. We can do a secondary flight plan, but we are not expecting an engine out. But if you do want to presume that you could get one because of heavy weather or anything, you always want to presume that it happens. You can copy active, and what we're gonna do is we'll do a secondary flight plan. We'll go to the very first waypoint, new destination, Lima, Foxtrot, Bravo Delta. That's what we're returning. Alright, that's our new destination. Runway 23 is good. We're going to enter arrival runway 23 as well. Return. Okay. And then what we're going to do here is we're going to do, if it says right turn to Bravo Delta, enter Bravo Delta. It is this one. And we'll right turn to Bravo Delta. And we need to hold, it doesn't say what altitude, because our transition is 5,000, oh, we'll go 5,000. Holds don't work at the moment, so we're not going to enter hold, any holds. And that's our secondary flight plan. So, we'll go back to performance, our first flight plan, and we'll continue down with the flows. So, 122.8. Our standard frequency for ATC, VHF2, VHF1 does what we need to speak in, interphone and cabin, you hear those good, make sure all switching is still normal. We could go through the pages, but it's not required, we already went through the necessary ones. Thrust efforts, make sure they're idle, masters off, most like normal, registration zero, parking brake set, gravity gear extension lever is down, and we'll set this to flight plan. Keep it as is, but we'll tune the same information. Okay, auto on all, standby clear, we'll set 2001. Alright, so that is set. We will now enter the glare shield information. Alright, a little bit of rain, that's nice. Constraints, VOR. ADF on this side, because you do have ADF tuned to VOR. Constraints, 10 nautical miles, and QNH, transition initial altitude is 5,000. Alright, dashed dots, so 3 dots, that's good. And now we gotta set our QNH. I believe it's 1001, but we're just gonna check with X-Spiral, make sure it agrees with us. 1002. Alright, change a little bit, that's fine. 1002. And we're gonna do the same thing with this. That's 1 time, 2 times, and 3 times. Set that as well. But we need to make sure our altitude is the same. Alright, right there. Perfect. That's 3 times set. And our glare shield is set. At this time, the captain and the first officer would both do their flows at the same time. But I like to do the first officer's side first, so we'll go there. I'm gonna do his flow. We check oxygen mask, not simulated, that's fine. Check everything here. Everything here is good. Brightness as you want it. You dim it at night because you want your eyes to get used to the night time so you can see outside better. So you dim it, but there's no need to. Alright, here we check a couple things. V2 and V1 are set. Climb, nav, blue, flight director 1 and 2. 5,000 feet blue, and QNH 1002. That's checked. All the information here is set. We also got our ADF tuned, and you can see it there. Check again, everything here is okay. And we'll go ahead and do the flight plan check. So flight plan, go through all the waypoints. Okay, that's checked. 701, back. Okay, 2, Toulouse, Lomra, Bukan, Pumal, Charlie Mago, 35, Charlie B, go. 1-1. Okay. So that flat plan is good. Notice continuities looks good and it agrees with our flat plan that we have in front of us. So no changes needed. Flat plan is checked. And now we move over to the captain's side. Again, same checks. Da da da. Climb blue, nav blue, V2, V1 set, flight director 1-2, 5,000 feet, and QNH 1002. Stuff's good here. We'll go and set terrain on this side. We don't need it. We actually need weather radar. Unfortunately, it's not simulated at the time, so we can't use it anyways. But that is perfectly fine as well. Okay. So, once we reach here, we are going to do some checks. So, we notice our fuel is done, so we'll turn that off. And we'll hit get, remove it, and I don't know why it does that. I think it's a door, honestly, that's blocking it, but it's kind of a hidden object. I don't, it's complicated. Anyways, alright, make sure our IRS are aligned, which they are. Takeoff data has been set. Flat plan A and B, we'll recheck that in a moment. Check our ATC code has been set, because at this before we would get IFR clearance. Right. In fact, we'd get IFR clearance as soon as we're done with our captain flows. We get IFR clearance, and then we'd make sure our information is set. That's all we're doing right now. Okay. Fuel quantity. Make sure it's checked, and we're not refueling anymore. And once we've checked that, turn on seatbelt signs. And turn our fuel pumps back to auto. Alright. With that, at this time, around this time in real life, the ground personnel would come up to the aircraft, to the captain, and the first officer given their load sheet, and this is where the real information is given to the captain, and this is when he revises his information. So, our load sheet for this simulation is here. We can enter our real information in INNETB now, and that is total zero fuel weight is 58.87, so I'm going to do 58.9 with a center of gravity of 33.9. Our block fuel is, check that here, 5.7. So some calculations have changed, barely though. And now we go back to performance. So, first things first, 33.2. So I got a little calculator here. 33.2 gives me 1.1 down. So I can already set down 1.1. Okay, data, that's what we're going to do now. So I'm going to recalculate some stuff here. I'm going to update this. We're doing runway 23. So weather has changed. So we're gonna change it here as well. This hasn't changed, this hasn't changed. Heading, headwind hasn't changed, temperature hasn't changed, QNH hasn't changed. Now this has changed, but these two values have not changed. So takeoff weight expected, zero fuel weight minus 300 kilograms. Actually no, it's sorry, gross weight minus 300. So 268, and we'll see if that changed anything. Nothing. So if nothing changed, that means we can keep it as it is. We've revised it. It is all good to go. So that revision has been done. After that revision, this is the time where we start our APU. So let's go and do that. Match switch on. Make sure the appropriate message, the appropriate display pops up, and then we'll start. I can step outside for a moment. Okay. Okay, here goes our APU. I'm going to get rid of some of this stuff. Cargo, goodbye. Catering, goodbye. APU's available. You can check that. So we can turn on the APU bleep. And we'll see that the packs slowly come online. Just like in real life, it takes a little time. That fault extinguishes, and then pack 2 fault should extinguish. There she goes. Perfect. We're done with pretty much everything to the point where we can now do the before start checklist. So, before start checklist above the line, logbook and security check has been checked and entered. Departure briefing is completed. Cockpit preparation is complete. Cam signs are on, auto and armed. Gears are in nav mode and aligned. Fuel is released with 5.7 tons. Bear F 1002 times 3 and parking brake is set. Above the line is completed. Let's go and call our pushback. We'll get it ready. Okay. Set.
Run to cockpit. Brother knowledge. Call me through the menu when you are ready. Run to cockpit. Okay. Tow is driving up.
Perfect. And once our tow is driving up, we'll do some pre-start checklists again. We'll do some flows. We want to make sure that our nose wheel steering is engaged. Indication is illuminated, but it isn't. It will, though. Knowing this plugin, it will. You'll see it. So ignore it for now. If in real life this wouldn't show up at this moment, you would turn off nose wheel steering already. So you don't have any nose wheel steering. Beacon comes on. Make sure windows, doors, and slides are armed, so you close everything, get rid of external power, and get rid of all of our ground connections, and hide all of the stuff. Okay, and we check that here.
All doors
are closed, and slides are armed. Okay. Thrust levers are idle, masters are off, falls like normal, parking brake set, and tracks are removed. Before start checklist below the line. Take up data is set. Beacon is on. Nose wheel steering disengaged. We'll check that in a moment. Windows, doors, slides are closed and armed. Cockpit doors closed and locked. We're good to go. Before start checklist is completed, and we can now push back.
Connected and bypass pin inserted. Release parking brake. Starting pushback and
you may start engaging. Release, and there you see the nose steering disengaged message. So, engine mode selector to start. I believe it's ignition. No, it's start. See the FedEx come online. Wow, 3.1. Some fast spinning. Wow. Alright, that's fair. Starting engine number 2 first. And we don't really necessarily have to watch this process. The engine should shut down automatically if something is wrong with them. But it's always good to have a look, cause anyways. Two is available. Starting engine number 1. It's unfortunately Xenviro's fault that as much precipitation as you can see, there's not a lot on the windshield. That's Xenviro's fault. Doing it with the fault weather will actually pretty much fill this up at this condition. So Xenviro needs to fix something there. But other than that, I like it. I like it a lot. Okay.
Operation complete. Set parking brake.
Parking brake is set, and engine number one should be now available.
Connecting tow. Stand by.
Here we go. Engine one available. Oops. Once I turn back to normal, I want to make sure that our wheel decam pops up. There she goes. If you bleed off, ground spoilers, arm, rudder trim 0, flaps set to 1. I bet you guys all want to see this. There you go. Flaps 1, set. Pitch trim, we set down 1.1. It's checked.
Bypass pin has been removed. Hand signal on the right. We'll see you next time on Hazard
Side. Because that is checked. That's normal. Anti-ice now comes on. We do need engine anti-ice. APU can come off. Nose steering is on. Communication is out. And we check the ECAN door page one more time. All slides are armed. That is good. Hand signals on the right, we're good to go. We're cleared, so after start checklist, anti-ice is on, pitch trim is 1.1 down set, pitch trim is 0, and the ECAM status is checked. Okay, because our taxi is fairly short, at least we'll just verify this. Actually no, we've got quite a distance. So yeah, we'll just do it here. Okay. So ignore what I was just about to say. So, those lights come to taxi. Parking brake can come off. Any last time, start get started if there's no A cars installed, which in X-Plane and any simulator there will not be A cars, so that's a given. So the airplane will start rolling by itself a little bit. We'll still give it that extra power that it needs. Taxi to our runway. Runway 23. Brake check. Alright, works. Alright, so. Okay. We can go and do it now. We do flight control check, so full right, full left, neutral, full up, full down, neutral, and then rudder, you need to do this, try to disconnect. Oh, I don't like this. Hold up, sorry. Full left, full right, neutral. Flight control check is completed. Once flight control check is completed, set your auto brake to max. And that is flight control check complete. Alright. thrust just a little bit. Looking at the taxi lines, it's possible that this is a converted scenery. That's okay. I mean, I didn't make it, so it's not my fault. I mean, I didn't post this. Yeah. Alright, so we're pretty much at the runway. We'll do the before takeoff procedures. We'll make sure that we're at the right runway, of course. We'll have the runway advisory in a moment, letting us know where we're at, which is helpful. Okay, flaps are set to 1, V1, 131, VR139, V2141, flex temperature 53 degrees. Is checked. Initial altitude is 5,000. Is checked. We would now turn on our radar as well, but not simulated once again, so nothing we can do there. Still our tray tables. Confirm our code one more time. Hit takeoff config. Alright, takeoff no blue. And do the before start checklist above the line. Before takeoff checklist above the line. Takeoff briefing completed. Flight controls are checked. Flight instruments are checked, flaps are 1, plan 1, set. You can almost take off no blue. Above the line completed. Okay. Brake fan is not needed. And at the time we request to enter the runway, we are cleared. No traffic that I see on our radar either, and in our sights either. So we'll go ahead and get onto the runway. And by doing that, we'll turn on our strobe lights. Runway turn off lights. Those lights at takeoff and extend our landing lights will not turn them on yet. Engine mode selector, we do not need, we'll set that, we'll keep that as normal. TCAS, TARA, and on. PAC's coming off. And runway advisory just gave us runway 23, and we can also see it here. So we're on the right runway. That's good.
On runway 23.
There it is again. I will stop right here. Brake on. A little misaligned, but that's okay. Alright. Before takeoff checklist below the line, cam signals given to you guys, TARA and PAX are off. We're now clear for takeoff, landing lights coming on. Chrono 1, 2, 3, and elapse pause. Parking brake release 50% and 1. I'm going to set, keep the brake, the brakes on because we are a short runway. Flex to customer runway. knots. Sorry, I had to. 100 knots. Wow, this turned terrible. Alright, we're still good. We won. Rotate. Pause rate, you're up. Nav green, lights out. Spoiler disarm. That was really bad. Throttle climb. Pack one coming on. I'll probably come in. Climb. Pack two coming on. Up. So 330. Bye bye, Volcador. To standard. Okay. After takeoff checklist. Landing gear up. Flaps retracted. Packs are on. Eco memo is checked. Her range to 80. Well, not much is done until we reach 10,000 feet. So once we reach 10,000 feet, things will happen. On the feet, we turn off anti-ice, but because we're still flying in clouds, which is basically moisture, we're still gonna keep it on. Exterior lights, landing lights coming off. See what size is required. We'll still keep it on. We'd adjust our radar tilt, but again, not simulated. Airport, back to VOR. Anything that we've entered manually in here. Delete our secondary flight plan as well. Performance page, then we'll go to progress and check our optimum altitude and maximum. I'll just set these one more time. Terrain comes off. it. If you just checked, now adjusting to climb towards 330. Now we're clearing the clouds just now. Still gonna keep anti-ice on for just a little moment. And the only other thing that happens is at 20,000 feet, that's when we'll, that's around the max amount, so we'll turn off our seatbelt signs and anti-ice as well. I don't think there's gonna be any turbulence further, so we'll go and do that now. Anti-ice coming off, seatbelt signs, auto, and therefore you guys are released. Thank you guys so much for watching. We'll see you in part 2, where we'll be landing into Barcelona in one of my pairware airplanes that I also bought, which is nice. See you guys. Adios.